Edition of WeatherScope.
Good evening. Welcome to this edition of WeatherScope. I'm Jeff Morrow in the Forecast Center, and our nor'easter finally appears to slowly be winding down. The effects aren't completely gone yet, though. We still have some heavy snow that is still going on in parts of the Ohio and Tennessee valleys. We'll talk more about that in a moment with our senior meteorologist here tonight. And we still have some coastal flooding potential, but the winds and the surf are gradually starting to die down a bit. Let's take a look at our storm on our current weather map. And again, graphically, the storm represented out here by this area of low pressure, and it continues to generally move away from the coast, but the winds wrapping around it, particularly on the northern side, are still funneling a lot of the air, a lot of the ocean, if you will, on into southeast areas of Massachusetts. And there are still storm warnings up from Watch Hill, Rhode Island to Chatham, Massachusetts. That means we could still have winds over 55 miles an hour and still some coastal flood warnings as well. Along the Jersey Shore, it has been a pretty nasty time of it. And right now we're going to go to Lori Geary. She's at Seabright, where she has been for the last 24 hours or so. And I bet you've seen a whole range of conditions there, Lori.
Yes, we sure have, Jeff, and things are finally starting to dry out. It's just not getting any warmer. Temperatures up around 34 degrees, but the wind chill is making it feel more like 13. We're right off of the main street here in Seabright. It's known as Ocean Avenue, or to the locals also as Route 36. We want to show you what it looked like just about 5 hours ago. Most folks managed to stay right on schedule, although travel was a little more difficult for those willing to take their chances. For those not willing to sacrifice their cars, well, the could always opt for the boat here on Beach Street. Water levels on these side roads off of Ocean Avenue were up around 3 feet. Tonight, the waters continue to recede almost back to where they came from. Winds are gusting up to 25 miles per hour. So for now, the Seabright area survives its strongest nor'easter of the season so far. Jeff, back to you in the Forecast Center.
All right, Lori, thanks for reporting to us, and we'll be wrapping things up with you in about a half an hour from now. All right, that was Lori Geary in Seabright, New Jersey. Right now, we want to bring in senior meteorologist Matt Crowther. And Matt, again, our nor'easter in the east starting to die down. Still some snow going on in the Midwest, though.
Yeah, some pretty amazing totals in Cincinnati and along the Ohio River Valley. In fact, record totals.
All right. First of all, let's show you a radar in the northeast. And this will pretty much show where the precipitation is. And it looks like, Matt, there's the northern southern edge right through Boston, but some drier air seems to be working its way in from the north.
That's right, as our storm pulls out to sea. A lot of this is freezing rain, so even though it's pretty light, notice we're not seeing any of these heavier levels. It's all the first color. But we've had quite a few freezing rain reports, and even down on the Cape, I think down around Falmouth, temperatures are down around 32 degrees now. So not very heavy, but as you know, freezing rain can make for very slippery travel, even if only a couple hundreds fall. So you got to be careful tonight from Boston southward.
All right, and there is our nor'easter, now starting to move a little bit more rapidly away to the northeast, and even the cloud cover appears to be, at least the enhanced cloudiness, appears to be diminishing a little bit over New England, but this, if anything, looks even more impressive in the Ohio Valley.
That's right, and this is a very interesting situation that happened. Earlier, if you were watching yesterday, you remember that there was a very strong moisture feed that came about like this, came in over the Mid-Atlantic and just was continuous all the way over the Ohio Valley, and so it was snowing heavily yesterday in the Cincinnati and Louisville areas. But what happened is our storm weighs way out here now. If you notice, there's a break in the moisture feed, and what's happened is a separate little upper level piece of energy has kind of stalled out right about in this area. So really the snow in the Ohio Valley is not really totally related to our nor'easter anymore, and it's still continuing.
Yeah, it is continuing, and check out some of these snowfall totals. As a matter of fact, they are records, all-time storms in Cincinnati and Louisville.
That's right. A bit unusual in that you'd think that Cincinnati and Louisville might get heavier snow totals than that, but quite often nor'easters will miss them, or the warm air will get up in there and it'll change it over to rain.
Right.
So it's unusual for them to get over a foot of snow, and these broke the records by 2 or 3 inches.
All right, and still some snow flying in this area, particularly a little sleet maybe mixing in there in southern parts of West Virginia, but we're not quite out of the woods as far as snow totals here.
That's right. As I pointed out, that upper level low pressure system is pretty much stationary, and we could see 3 or 4 more inches, so we might get up close to 20 inches in the Cincinnati area. That's just astounding.
That is astounding, really, from a storm like this, which actually the center not got anywhere close to Cincinnati. All right, thanks, Matt Crowther. We'll be back with you in about a half an hour. And again, you can always tune in here to the Weather Channel and get the latest on this storm, but this isn't the only game in town, folks. We have yet another storm moving into the west, and with more on that, let's go back to the studio.
Not to be outdone, a storm is walloping the west coast. More rain is over the region. It's creating hazardous conditions like flooding and the potential for mudslides. For more on the punch being delivered to the Pacific, we turn now to reporter Patricia Haverty. She's standing by in Daly City, just south of San Francisco. Patricia.
Well, actually, we are enjoying about a 3.5 hour break from the rain right now. But for the people along this stretch of roadway, about 6 homes on Avalon Drive here, dark windows because these people have gotten out tonight. The reason, the roadway in front of their house has basically fallen into the ocean. Evacuations are also the order of the day north of San Francisco. Record flooding, some say disastrous flooding, is expected for the Russian River tomorrow. The river is expected to crest 16 feet over flood stage tomorrow, and officials are strongly recommending that residents there, even those who consider themselves flood wise, that they leave the area tonight. We also have received reports that they are getting some heavy rain north of San Francisco right now, and that it is headed in our direction. We'll keep you posted. Reporting live from Daly City.